Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we are going to discuss real numbers and its properties. First of all, let us discuss what are real numbers. Rational numbers and irrational numbers combine to form a set called the set of real numbers. Now the real numbers can be positive, negative, or zero. Now any number you can think of is a real number. Numbers like 2, 14.23, -0.23, 2/3, √3, and 1090 are all real numbers. Now the numbers which are not real are square root of -1, which is an imaginary number, and infinity is not a real number. Now here the real numbers are shown diagrammatically, and here we have not real numbers, which are the imaginary numbers, and infinity. Now here n denotes the set of natural numbers which start from 1, so it contains 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. Now if we add 0 to the set of natural numbers, then we get the set of whole numbers, which contains the elements 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. Now the set of natural numbers is a subset of the set of whole numbers. Now the whole numbers are positive, and if we add the negative numbers in this set, that is -1, -2, -3, and so on, then we get the set of integers, which is denoted by I. Now if to the set of integers, if we add non-integral values like 1/2, 1/3, 2/3, and so on, then we get the set of rational numbers, which is denoted by Q. Now, to the set of rational numbers, if we add irrational numbers like √2, √3, √5, and so on, then we get the set of real numbers, which is denoted by R. So it is clear from the diagram that the set of natural numbers is a subset of the set of whole numbers. Then the set of whole numbers is a subset of set of integers, and the set of integers is a subset of the set of rational numbers, and these all are the subsets of the set of real numbers. Now let us discuss the properties of real numbers. Now let P, Q and R are any three real numbers. Now let us discuss the properties of real numbers for the operations of addition and multiplication. First is the closure property. The closure property for addition is, if we add any two real numbers, that is P and Q, then the result, which is P plus Q, is also a real number. And in case of multiplication, if we multiply any two real numbers, that is P and Q, then the result, which is P into Q, is also a real number. Now the second property is the commutative property. The commutative property for addition is, if P and Q are two real numbers, then P plus Q is equal to Q plus P. And for multiplication, it is P into Q is equal to Q into P. Now the third property is the associative property. In case of addition, it is, if P, Q and R are any three real numbers, then P plus Q the whole plus R is equal to P plus Q plus R the whole. And in case of multiplication, it is P into Q the whole into R is equal to P into Q into R the whole. And the next is identity. In case of addition, for each real number P, P plus 0 is equal to 0 plus P is equal to P, that is 0 is the identity element for the operation of addition. And in case of multiplication, for each P, that is for each real number P, P into 1 is equal to 1 into P is equal to P, that is 1 is the identity element for the operation of multiplication. Now fifth is inverse. In case of addition, for each real number P, there is unique real number minus P called the additive inverse of P, such that P plus of minus P is equal to minus P plus P is equal to 0. And in case of multiplication, for each real number P, which is not equal to 0, number one by b called the multiplicative inverse of b such that b into 1 by b is equal to 1 by b into b, which is equal to 1. Now next property is the distributive property, which is common to both addition and multiplication. Now according to this, if P, Q and R are any three real numbers, then P into Q plus R the whole is equal to P into Q the whole plus P into R the whole. And this is called the left distributive property. And for any three real numbers P, Q and R, Q plus R the whole into P is equal to Q into P the whole plus R into P the whole. And this is called the right distributive property. So in this session we have learned about real numbers and its properties. And this completes the session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.